हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दी कैडकैम सीएई लेक्चर सीरीज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द मिलिंग ऑपरेशन। वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन द ड्रिलिंग ऑपरेशन एंड ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ लूप प्रोग्रामिंग, कैन साइकिल प्रोग्रामिंग एंड मैक्रो सब रूटीन प्रोग्रामिंग। सो नाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द मिलिंग ऑपरेशन एंड द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन द basic difference between the drilling operation and milling operation is the drilling operation is a point to point operation and milling operation is a path operation. So we while we are doing milling, okay, we are very precise about what path we are following, and when it comes to the path following, then there are these important codes which we need to understand. So let's say this is a tool, okay, and this kind of rough path it has to follow. So what are the codes involved over here? So the first code for the linear interpolation, when the tool is going to travel say a straight line path, then it is a linear interpolation, so G01. When the tool is supposed to travel the circular path but the direction is clockwise, so let's say here the direction is clockwise, okay, so for following a clockwise circular path, okay, we have circular interpolation clockwise, that is G02. Okay, again the tool will have to move along a straight line by G01, reach point number 3, and from point number 3 to point number 4, tool has to travel a circular path but in the anti-clockwise direction. So this is anti-clockwise direction and this is clockwise direction. Okay, so anti-clockwise direction, we have circular interpolation clockwise, circular interpolation counterclockwise or anti-clockwise, so that is G03. Okay, so this is the very important thing that we need to understand. Okay, another important thing that we need to keep in mind is the diameter compensation of the cutter. So when we say tool is supposed to follow a path, okay, so it is the tool center that is supposed to follow the path. Okay, so any reference for the tool is its center, and the center coordinate is supposed to follow the path. Okay, now if I have to machine this, okay, if I have to ask the tool to follow this path, okay, then tool has certain diameter, and if the tool center is going to follow this path, then we will be ending up by reducing the workpiece dimension. Okay, so instead what we do is we create an offset path, okay, to the actual path. What we create an offset path to the actual path. So this dotted line represents the offset path, and we keep on calculating the offset path dimensions based on the cutter diameter, and that is what we call as the cutter diameter compensation. We basically keep on adding and subtracting radius of the cutter wherever it is necessary. So as far as the tool path is concerned, tool path offset with respect to profile, okay, tool path parallel to profile path with offset equal to R, where R is the cutter radius, and need to recalculate the coordinates. So let's say I have this example where the tool is supposed to follow a change the direction. So from horizontal it is coming and now it has to change the direction. So how we calculate the center of the cutter? Okay, how we calculate the coordinates of the center of the cutter? So let's say this endpoint of the profile, that is workpiece profile, is x comma y. The cutter is having radius r. So while it is going to change its direction from horizontal to vertical, okay, I can easily calculate its offset path value at all stages as x dash equal to x plus r, y dash equal to y plus r. It is very straightforward. I don't have to calculate much because we are working with straight line motions and G01 is activated, and the offset path calculation is the offset distance everywhere is going to be R. So that's what we are doing here, X dash equal to X plus R, Y dash equal to Y plus R. Same happens when the tool is supposed to follow the motion in a vertical direction and then in the horizontal direction below the path. Okay, below the path. So let's say this is my top plane, okay, and generally we say the bottom left corner of the workpiece is my origin. So if this is the origin, the offset path calculation would require to subtract the radius of the tool. So that's what we are doing. So if in this particular direction I have to find out the offset, okay, then I will be subtracting the radius of the tool in such a way x dash equal to x minus r, y dash equal to y minus r. Okay, so these two cases are pretty straightforward. Okay, come to the third case where the tool has to follow a circular path, okay, and we need to find out the offset path. Okay, so how the offset path calculation can be done? So I have the radius of the workpiece, okay, which needs to be followed by the tool, which needs to be machined by the tool. Okay, and in order to calculate its offset path, we are just going to add the radius of the cutter with the radius of the workpiece. So it is r dash, which is going to be the offset path radius, will be given by the radius of the workpiece plus radius of the tool. So this is also quite straightforward. Okay, we need to do some calculation when the tool is supposed to travel a ramp up and ramp down distance. So let's say the tool is coming from a horizontal path and then it has to go up at an angle. It has to go up at an angle. So once these situations are here, now I must say these lines are, let's say, the lines which will be which are not exactly present. The line which is present is only this. So this is a workpiece. Okay, these are the extensions of these lines. Okay, this line as well as this line and this line. These are extension lines. Just to calculate the offset path in this particular case. So I have alpha is the inclination. Okay, of the ramp, inclination angle of the ramp. Then the tool comes here. The tool has to pass this extension line of the ramp angle. Okay. And then it has to stop here. Okay, it is continuously in contact with the horizontal line. It has to pass the extension line and stop here. This is the location of the change of the tool path. Okay, it is going to occur at this point. So we mark this point as x dash y dash. The corner point of the workpiece is x1 y1, and the tool now has to reach a point x2 y2 up the ramp. Okay, so now little construction. Okay, I have just joined the end point of the workpiece with the tool center. Okay, end point of the workpiece with the tool or cutter center. Okay, and this angle is basically the half angle of alpha. So let's say this is the extension and this is the extension of the horizontal line. So the total angle is alpha. Okay, if I join the center of the cutter with this point, okay, it divides it into exactly half the total angle. So it is alpha by 2. So now I have these two triangles. I am trying to identify what is this offset distance delta x in terms of horizontal direction, because I already have the offset distance r in terms of y dimension. Okay, so this calculation is pretty easy. This is only y plus r, or rather y minus r. Okay, now since it has to go ramp up, so I have to find this delta x. Okay, this delta x is not x1, it is greater than x1. Okay, so rather it is greater than this r as well. Okay, so how do we calculate? I have this construction triangle. Okay, so this angle is alpha by 2, and I know this vertical distance is r and this delta x. So I need to establish a relation between these three. So it's very simple. I find the tan of the angle. So tan of the angle is r divided by delta x. Tan of the alpha 2, alpha by 2, is equal to r by delta x. I want to find delta x. I will cross interchange the locations of delta x and tan alpha by 2. So delta x is basically r divided by tan of alpha by 2. And once I get the delta x value, then I find out the x dash equal to x1 plus delta x, and then y dash is equal to y1 minus r. So I get the corner point from where the direction of the tool can be changed, and it will conveniently follow the ramp up direction. The same condition happens, but slightly different calculation is a ramp down. So while it is coming in this direction and then it has to go ramp down, okay, the calculation as far as y offset is very simple, because y will be having an offset distance equal to the cutter radius r. So y dash will be y2 plus r. Now this angle is alpha, Now what is happening again? The angle that we are calculating is this particular angle is alpha by 2. Okay, again we make the construction. Okay, similar construction as we made here. This angle calculation is alpha by 2, and again we calculate the delta x in a similar manner, which is given by r upon tan alpha by 2, and then we get the point value where from which point the cutter is going to change its direction and start the ramp down motion is x dash equal to x 2 plus delta x. Okay, x 2 plus delta x, and y dash is equal to y 2 plus r. So this particular distance, okay, this delta x distance is what we are interested to calculate. So once these things are known to us, okay, then it becomes very easy to write a simple milling program. Okay, so we'll just write a simple milling program. So now we will continue with the example of manual part programming. So this is the sample part, and the circle is the tool, and the tool is going to follow the workpiece, okay, in the stated manner, and the dimensions of the workpiece are mentioned. Okay, these are the tool locations, okay, the way it is going to follow the workpiece, and this is the tool path. So this is the offset tool path created so that the workpiece and tool, okay, they are just in contact with each other, or in other words, the tool just touches the workpiece and then follows the side milling process or contour milling process. And the tool is having cutter diameter 6 millimeters. The speed of the spindle is 3000 RPM and feed rate is 300 millimeters per minute. The plate thickness is 12 mm. So for this operation, we are using milling cutter, that is 6 millimeter end mill cutter. So we will take the tool down up to minus 12, and then we will start the tracing of the offset tool path, and this program we are going to write only to trace this path once. So this is a manual part program example to trace this tool path once. So it is going to start from point number 1, then go to 2. Everywhere it is linear interpolation. So we will be writing a modal code G01 once, and then we will keep on changing the coordinates till we reach back to location number 1. So from some home set point location, the tool is going to approach location number 1, and then it is going to start its linear interpolation motion at the specified feed rate, 300 millimeters per minute. So it will go from location 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, and 6 to 1 again. So for that purpose, the program is written. So the start of the program with percent sign followed by the program number. The milling cutter dia 6 millimeter, x0 y0 is the bottom left of the path. So as you can see, this is the origin. Okay, this point is basically x0 y0. This is the origin. Okay, and we have set point somewhere here. So let's say this is my set point, which is away from origin. Which is away from origin, and the coordinates are minus 40, minus 40, 20. So I will start my sequence number, then I will first write G00, G71, G90. Okay. Now, since this is the first program, where we are writing the milling, we are writing the program to trace the path of a for a contour milling operation. So we can also write the cancellation codes just to be rest assured. So G71, G90, and I can write G80, G49. Okay, so these are the codes for cancellation of the CAN cycle, then cutter diameter compensation off, and then I have my usual metric programming and absolute positioning system. So then I reposition the or reset the home point using G92 command to X-40, Y-40, Z20, resetting the set point. Then I will be changing the tool to tool number 01, so using the M06 command. Then in a rapid mode, I will take the tool to the location number 1 and I will be lowering its Z coordinate to Z-12, so that the, or for that matter, I can lower it to Z-13 to be precisely finishing the bottom layer. Precisely finishing the bottom layer of the workpiece. Switch on the spindle in clockwise direction with the spindle speed is expected is 3000, not 1200. We'll just change these values. So spindle speed is 3000. Okay, then G01. I will be starting up with the linear interpolation command. So from location number 1, the tool will be taken in a linear interpolation manner, straight line motion to Y33. So this is -3, -3. So if this is my origin, which is 0, 0, the tool diameter is 6, so tool center will be -3, -3, just what we saw here. Yeah, same situation. So I will be subtracting the 0, -R, 0, -R to get the starting coordinates, and that is how I get here -3, -3. And from here it is going to go up. So then here it is going to be in terms of X, it will still remain as the 0, -3. That is -3, and in terms of Y it is going to be 30 plus 3. So then, since my X coordinate is not changing while I am doing G01 motion over here from location 1 to location 2, I am only going to change the Y coordinate. So that is the reason why after G01 I have only written the coordinate which is changing, so that is Y33. And the feed rate expected is 300 millimeters per minute, and I will switch on the flood type coolant. Now once I reach this location 2, okay, I have to change the direction. So now I will be changing only X coordinate. So from X-3, now the new X coordinate expected is, see, this is 30, this is total 90. So this point is at 60. So still the tool is on the left side of the workpiece. So 60 minus the radius of the tool, so 60 minus 3, that is 57. So the coordinate that is changing is X-57. It is already in linear interpolation mode with 300 millimeters per minute feed rate. So now as I give the changing locations, okay, it is going to follow a straight line motion at this given speed, feed and given speed, and it will do the side milling operation. So X57 is the third location, then it goes vertically up to location 4, up to Y63. These are all absolute coordinates. Okay, these are all absolute coordinates. Then after 4 it goes to X93, Y93, because it is going to pass the 90 mark, and 90 plus the radius, so that will be 90 plus 3, that is 93. Then it will come down vertically to location number 6. Now here the 93 will not change, but Y coordinate will change back to -3. So from X93 to Y-3, that is location number 6, and from location number 6 it will come back to the starting point, that is location number 1, which was X-3, Y-3. So already Y-3 we have got over here. Now X-3 will take our tool back to the location number 1. So once it reaches the location 1, as I told earlier, we are just going to write a manual part program to trace this path once. If we are going to write if we are going to simulate this using any software, then we can give considerable depth of cut, and keep on repeating the path, okay, with the specified depth. So there I can put the entire thing in a Cayan cycle mode, okay, and every time, let's say, I can change the depth and follow the same motion, change the depth, follow the same motion, or I can even write this motion into a separate program, and then I can keep on calling that program just like a subrouting program. That is also possible. There are various ways if you are going to do this using a simulation software, CAM simulation software, then the software itself will give us various options to write a program. So this is just an effort to trace this path once, okay, trace the milling path once, and then I am switching off the spindle and switching off the coolant supply. Then I am writing, changing the mode to rapid mode and taking the tool back to the set point, and then the program ends. So I hope this particular program is understood well. As you can see, I have written it manually, and the comments, appropriate comments, are written at the end of the each block. And we have studied about the offset tool paths, and this offsetting is the diameter compensation offsetting, okay, is carried out over here, okay, and this is just an effort how to calculate the offset path for the milling operation tool path generation. So I hope you have understood. Okay, hope to see you next time with more such interesting content. Thank you very much.